In today's video, I'm going to show you the three steps it takes to set up an external instrument to be controlled with Ableton Live. And if you stick around to the end, I'm going to give you some tips for incorporating this into your live setup. Brett Pontecorvo here at LiveKeyboardist.com, where I help keyboard players just like you with the ins and outs of sound design with Ableton Live and with creating an excellent live keyboard rig. If you're new here, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. All right, so these are the things that you are going to need. First of all, you're going to need an external instrument. Today I'm using the MicroKorg XL, but any external instrument will do. You're going to need an audio interface, and I use the Sapphire Pro 24, but I've got a link to a very similar one in the description if you need one. You'll need a MIDI cable to connect your external device to Ableton, and you'll also need an audio cable to plug into your external device to go into your audio interface. So once you've got all of those things, we'll head over into Ableton and start setting this up. So our first step is going to be to fix our audio preferences. So we can open up our audio preferences, and we're going to head down to output. Now, as I mentioned, I am using the MicroKorg XL. The output lets Ableton know where to send MIDI. So for our sound MIDI output for our MicroKorg, we'll want to make sure track is turned on. Now, if you're using a drum machine, you will also want to have sync turned on. And if you're hoping to control any of the internal parameters, you'll need remote turned on. However, in this case, I just want to import those sounds into Ableton so that I can manipulate them. So I will turn my sound output on. So step two is to set up an external instrument device in Ableton. So underneath our instruments, we'll choose external instrument, and we'll just drop it in there. And we'll have now this little device here that we're going to configure in order to send MIDI out to our MicroKorg and receive it back in Ableton Live. So under MIDI 2, we'll choose MicroKorg XL Sound. And what's going to happen now is any MIDI coming into this channel strip is going to be sent to my MicroKorg. But now we have to capture the sound. So I actually have the output of my MicroKorg plugged into the input of my audio interface. So underneath audio from, I'm going to choose channel 2, which is where I have my audio running to. We can use this gain knob to just make sure that we're not clipping. Or if it's too quiet, you can use it to boost. And then under hardware latency, this is how you're going to adjust to make sure that you're not feeling a major delay between when you press the key and when sound is made. So I actually like to switch this to samples because I want it to be pretty immediate. Get that level set correctly. All right, so at this point we have set it up, but you've made it to the part of the video where I'm going to show you how you can actually incorporate this into a live setup. So if we go ahead and group this, we're going to get an instrument rack, and this allows us to really easily turn things on and off. And if you want to know more about this, you can check out the card above. But I'm going to move my chain selector over to 1. And then now I can use this to toggle my sound on and off. So I'll go ahead and MIDI map a button. We'll set the maximum to 1. And now I can toggle my sound on and off, using just that one button, but you might also want to change sounds, and Ableton allows you to do that as well. So when you open up a blank MIDI clip, if you check out here underneath the notes section, which if that's hidden, you can pop it open by clicking this, you're going to see bank, sub, and program. Now every keyboard is different, but the MicroKorg is pretty simple and it doesn't receive bank messages. So for my first patch, I can set this to 1-1, and when I fire it, I'm going to get this polysynth. And maybe for my next patch, I want a bass sound. So bass sounds are on channel 2. So I'll do 1, 2, and fire this clip. and now I've got a bass sound. Now, if you found this video helpful and you're looking for more, you can check out on the screen right now how to use contact as an external instrument. And in addition to that, if you're curious about how I was navigating the screen, you can check out my top 10 keyboard shortcuts. If you found this video helpful, please consider giving it a like and a subscribe, and I will see you next time on LiveKeyboardist.com.